Well, they are in need, vulnerable, and apparently soon to be out on the street. Tonight, an all-new 11 News investigation focuses on people getting cut out of a government program that they say they depend on. 11 News reporter John Sherman is live with that exclusive story tonight. John.
Well, Marianne, tonight you'll meet two people your taxes pay to hell. Our story takes us to Cecil County, where there's controversy brewing over who does and does not get that assistance. If some people get all the breaks in life, Mike Peters got all his early.
Well, I was 17 years old. I played high school football, the best in this county.
But his life as the star athlete ended July 14th, 1994. Mike's scrapbook lays it out. The most popular guy in school lost it all in an instant.
I was in a coma for 40 days, followed by 13 months in the hospital for rehab. And when I came out of the hospital, none of my friends, I had no friends, none.
The twisted metal bent and ripped apart the life Skip Peters had imagined for his son.
Well, it was hard to see him go from a football field to a wheelchair. That was a tough time.
They told Mike he'd never walk and never talk again.
The doctor said that I would never graduate. If I ever did, it'd be years later, years afterwards.
But you proved him wrong.
Then you kissed mine.
But that brings us to where Mike is today, 31 years old, trying to live as an independent adult, and because of his traumatic brain injury, incapable of controlling what he says at times, making working around other people impossible. He's staying at his parents' house this week because sheriffs could show up to evict him from his apartment at any time, and his dad's worried about how he'd react. Mike had been getting Section 8 money from HUD to pay most of his rent.
It's very embarrassing. I mean, I'm an able man. I'm smart and intelligent, but I have to rely on other people to give me money. It sucks. I want to be able to earn my own living.
Cecil County's housing department decides who gets the federal program's money, and all of a sudden, Mike Peters is off the list, shut out. The reason, according to his lawyer, he didn't send one form in on time.
Speechless. I was like, I can't believe this. Why? What did I do?
The director of Cecil County's housing department, Dave Mahaney, is the one who makes the decisions about who gets the Section 8 money here.
Heartless, you know, I mean, it's like, it's just very cruel.
It's hard sometimes because he likes a lot of attention.
The Peters aren't alone. Not too far away, Nakia Battles also questioning the decisions made by Dave Mahaney about who gets Section 8 money. She's a single mother of five.
Then there's China, Markia. She's seven.
While she'll be the first to tell you she made mistakes early in life, there are signs all over her apartment of a family on the rise. On this night, her mom's watching all the kids but nine-month-old Keenan so Nikki can study.
Trying to be a registered nurse. I'm going to college right now for that.
She showed us her grades, all very near the top. Three of her kids are also on the honor roll at their schools, too. She credits the Section 8 HUD money.
I greatly appreciate the assistance that I got from HUD. When I got on the program, I didn't have my license. I didn't have a car of my own. I wasn't working. But that's turned everything around for me.
Keenan's father watches the kids when Nakia has class. While she presented the county with a signed affidavit from his landlord and mail to that other address, Dave Mahaney kicked Nakia and her kids out of the program anyway.
Because of an assumption that I had an unauthorized person living with me, they, Section 8, terminated my Section 8 assistance.
While that decision has turned her life upside down, it was what Nakia saw in the parking lot at the county building that hurt the most. The rumors she'd heard were true.
I couldn't believe my eyes.
Dave Mahaney, the director of the agency that deals with low-income single mothers more than any other, has this plastered on his car. Can't feed him, don't breed him.
He's the director driving around with this bumper sticker saying, if you can't feed him, don't breed him. Am I supposed to be sorry that I had my children? I love my children.
Tomorrow night on 11 News at 11, we'll put our questions to Dave Mahaney and hear about who else is questioning his decisions. Reporting live, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.